This is the view when we got there, and as you can see, the waves have straightened out. Swell has dropped. It's a lot smaller than it has been this past week, but at least the waves are doing a little bit better. Today was Greg's day. That's Greg taking off on a right, and I will tell you, he got a ton of waves today. What I did this morning is to take all the videos shot by Larry and myself and merge them together in a chronological order, so some of these waves are duplicates but from different angles. That's David going left. I wanted to mention that when I'm narrating this videos, actually in the program, I've got a really tiny screen that's about 2.5 inches diagonal. And so you can imagine it's difficult to see exactly who's on it. That's why I've mentioned in the past, and I'm going to repeat it today, when people have boards that are distinguishable. For example, Greg is writing a board that he picked up. It's got a flower design on the nose, and it's a soft deck. If I remember, it's a greenish-blue deck. It's so easy to spot. There goes Greg again. You can see his board real easily, even on this tiny screen I'm working with. Yep, it's a green deck with the front nose area has a blue floral on it. One of the most repeated questions that has been asked, that's David going left, and that is, why can't you film a little bit lower or video lower? Because the waves look smaller when you're flying, let's just say 25, 30 feet above your head, the people that are surfing their head. And the reason you can't go any lower is because of the salt water. And when a wave breaks, that's a curse that was on that last wave. When a waves come in, and let's say it's 5 foot wave, it breaks, and then you have the spray. And even at the altitude I'm videoing, that could be Kurt, I'm not sure. Then when my drone comes back, I've got moisture on the skids, and you know, salt water is not good for anything. And as far as moving parts and creating rust and things like this, so that's why we fly in a rather safe area. The bigger the waves, the higher up we have to go because of the spray. Looks like Greg. You wonder why Greg's getting so many waves. It's because he has a board that fits his size. And I noticed a lot of people, there he is sitting right there, and there you can see his board. Look how colorful it is. So it's so easy to spot. But if you're riding a short board, you're going to get just quite a small amount of waves. Whereas if you get a board that's going to float you, it's easier to pick up the waves. It's just common sense. But for some reason, I'm not sure why people want to ride a shortboard. And I know they're more maneuverable, but you don't pick up as many waves. Looks like Greg again. Today is his day. I wanted to mention that the swell is supposed to pick up, and actually, there he is again, Greg. Gosh, you got so many waves. It was great to see you out there. Really nice ride. Anyway, the swell is supposed to pick up, start to build this afternoon, and by tomorrow morning it should be over 6 foot. So if you can make it out tomorrow morning, we'll be out there videoing. But don't tell anybody else, because you don't want it too crowded, right? Greg going left. See how his board sticks out like a sore thumb. Greg, I hope you don't sell that board. Greg's nickname, by the way, is the Board Broker. He buys surfboards a lot and goes through them buying low and selling. Makes his money, but that's okay. Greg's surfboard, man, is just great. Greg's okay too. There he is again. Maybe the same wave from a different perspective. Another nice ride. That was David on a shortboard. Should have been riding the pickle today. Good shortboard ride. It's Kurt. David cranking it. I know Luke was out here and he had some weights, but I didn't comment because I didn't recognize his board. He normally has a mustard colored board, but he had a different board today. Nice wave.
great.
For today. I know it's not epic, it's not excellent, but it was a lot better than it's been all week. Very wave-starved.
Thank you.